Hello, this video is to promote a video game called Curb Kids. It's an educational video game aimed at children, and hopefully it will get into schools and things. It's created by Lappin Logic, but they've hit a bit of a bump and they need our help. This video is basically explaining all, and there's a little snippet from Headway, which is a brain injury trust, explaining how we can help, and I sincerely hope that you all can lend a little helping hand, because this game is very good, and I think it needs to get out there. So let's help out as best we can. Okay, enjoy the video.
Computer games. From the bip-bop of the ball hitting the pong paddles from the early 70s, through racing games to football, roleplay and platforms like Mario. The medium is worth more than the movie industry and is available everywhere, from your television to your phone. Now, a Jersey company has been formed to marry gaming and education, specifically road safety. Paul Arnold had the idea for Lappin Logic while working at the States of Jersey Police.
The opportunity arose to create a road safety game for them, which I sort of jumped at the chance for. Ever since then, it's kind of sort of snowballed from there. And now we're here with a nearly finished demo.
Paul studied computer game design at university, but couldn't get work in the field when he took a job as finance officer for the police. The idea to merge the two came about.
I mean, I went to the police press office and told them my background and sort of said, what kind of games would the police need if they needed any at all? And they said that road safety was a very sort of current issue for them, and it's something they were really trying to get behind. And they said, could you do something along those lines? And I said, well, you know, I'll give it my best shot.
This isn't your ordinary education game, though. Here's Paul.
Kind of, you know, kids are very, very sort of hard to impress nowadays. You know, at home they've got all the latest consoles, be it, you know, Xbox 360, PS3s, etc. And, you know, you can't just show them a Flash game and expect them to be impressed by it. You've got to really sort of, you know, up your game and create something that's like on a par with what they play at home.
That led to the 3D road safety game, which will eventually work on a range of devices from phones to laptops to tablets and even games consoles. I asked Paul to talk me through the game demo so far.
Well, I mean, the demo, we started development June 19th and we finished to the stage we've got to now on June 17th, so it was a year's worth of development. We have a sort of basic area, sort of like an estate, basically, a council estate, I guess you could call it. And there's a road, a ring road running through it, and there's cars driving up and down, also people milling around that you can talk to and just have basic conversations with. The main part of it is obviously the crossing the road minigame, which has been implemented, and that's basically consists of two kind of rainbow strips. We have one which sort of lets the child know how close to the edge of the pavement they should be standing, and the second is how, you know, in how straight a direction they should be crossing, because what Curbcraft teaches, which is the teaching method we've tried to mimic, is you know, a child should be crossing in a straight line, otherwise it's, you know, it's risky.
Music is a big part of computer games, and sound designer Chris Watson sampled Crosstown Traffic by Jimi Hendrix.
Well, yeah, basically, I've done a lot of research on lots of different kind of children's game music, things around at the moment, but I think a big part of what I've done and had a look into is that with any game that you play at any age, really, especially when you're a child, you remember the music sometimes more than the gameplay when you get older. So I've just done a lot of research and just found out, trying to find different sounds which maybe people more respond to well, or music that people like at the moment and people that liked in the last kind of 15 years of gaming at least. So
it hasn't all been plain sailing, and there is a long way to go. Paul's emptied his own bank account to get the basic demo running so far.
Handing out, you know, it's kind of asking people, very kind people, hopefully, for money. We've gone as far as we can go so far with this demo, and obviously we've got a business plan behind us as well. So we're going to have to start going to investors, be they angel investors or, you know, corporate sponsors and things like that, and just say, you know, what do you think, and would you be willing to help us out on this venture? Well, the demo so far has cost me about $10,500 to develop. I mean, obviously, I'm very lucky in the fact that I have good friends who work in the games industry who've been helping me out. So it has been mates' rates in a way. It probably would have been four times that much had it not been. So I feel very blessed in that respect. But yes, $10,500 so far.
If they get the funding, then in a year, every primary school child in Jersey could be using the game to teach them about road safety. If that goes well, a game developed in Jersey, tested on Jersey children, could be helping children around the world learn those same skills.
Headway Jersey, the brain injuries charity, not only helps support the survivors of brain injury and their families, but also supports the prevention of brain injury. As an educational tool, Curb Kids is ideal for helping to prevent brain injury and stopping children from having accidents. And we would like you to support this venture. If you could support them on Patreon, that would be fantastic. Thank you.